Live from the International McNeil Studios in beautiful Baja Tustin, we have Professor Mark McNeil talking about utility. And now I'm off to spring break, but first I'm going to listen to this lecture.
Hello, it's time to talk about utility and consumer choice. This is about how households make decisions. And we have to make assumptions about households, and that is, first, that they're rational. Now, this doesn't mean rational in a real way, but rather in a very simple way. That is, that people prefer more to less, and they attempt to maximize. That is, they economize. They do the best with what they can, what they have available. Next, there are lots of choices about what consumers can buy. Heaven knows there are choices. That they face positive prices. People aren't giving the stuff away. And constraints exist. The constraints are limiting factors like income, time, etc. So, given your limits, how do you maximize your well-being? So, this is a fairly simple example, and in order to talk about it, we have to talk about what is utility. The question is, does utility mean usefulness? No. People buy some of the most useless things there are. They spend their hard-earned money, like chia pets, for instance. Can you suggest something that is useless but people spend their hard-earned money on?
Textbooks.
Textbooks. I don't think I'm going there, Holmes. It means satisfaction. That people buy things because it gives them satisfaction, not usefulness. And of course, that is subjective. That means what gives some people satisfaction and value, like textbooks, may not give it to others. And finally, I have to introduce the idea of a util. A util is one measured unit of satisfaction. Now, I realize you say in the real world there aren't utils, but I can tell you, utils, they're working on them. They're working on them. At this very moment, people are studying brain patterns, and they're going to hook a person up to this apparatus, and then they're going to feed them a Snickers bar, and their brain's going to, and there's going to be a needle. 16. 16 what? 16?
Utils!
That's right.
Because Snickers satisfies.
That's right. 16 utils worth. Okay, then we have to distinguish between total and marginal utility because this is economics, and when people make a decision, they always compare the marginal benefits against the marginal cost. So we don't care about total, we don't care about average, we care about marginal. So let me explain why. I drink disgusting tea on a Saturday night when I prefer something else. First of all, here's quantity of beer, let's see, Dos Equis, versus tea. If I have a Dos Equis on a Saturday night, I get 43 utils from it. If I take a second Dos Equis, it goes to 68 utils. That's my total from drinking two Dos Equis. If I have another one, it goes to 88. Another one, it goes to 98. If I have a fifth, it goes to like 103. If I have a sixth, it goes to 103. And if I have a seventh, there's no telling. It'd be like 58, but we'll leave that one alone. If I have tea on a Saturday night, I get 3 utils from it. And if I have a second cup of tea, my total increases to, well, actually it goes to 2. So, how many added or marginal utils do I get? Marginal utility is the change in total utility divided by the change in the quantity of the good consumed. So when I take the first Dos Equis, my total goes from 0 to 43, 43 utils from the first, marginal utils. When I have the second, my total goes from 43 to 68, that's 25 utils attributable to my consumption of the second unit. This one is 20 additional utils if I take the third, 10 if I take the fourth, and 5 if I, is that 5? Yes, mm-hmm. If I take, and this one, 0. And it would it could perhaps be negative, but nobody's stupid enough to take anything like this into a negative utility zone. Certainly none of you. Okay. If I take the first T, I get 3 marginal yields. If I take the second T, -1. I don't like T. So, have we distinguished between total utility and marginal utility? Yes, we have. Have we explained why I drink tea on Saturday night? No. Here's why. I come into the kitchen on Saturday night, and I have my choices to have this cup, this Dos Equis, or that cup of tea. I choose Dos Equis. Boom. Yes? Delicious. I count the utils as I drink them. Then, I come back in, my choice is to have the second Dos Equis or the first cup of tea. 25 marginal utils versus 3. I take the second one. The third, oh, I take the third one. The fourth, oh. The fifth, yeah, I'm sorry. And finally, no, I drink tea on Saturday night. Can you imagine? And what drives me to it? Marginal utility. But it's not just marginal utility, there's something called the law of diminishing marginal utility. Law of diminishing marginal utility. And this shows diminishing marginal utility, which says, as more of a good is consumed, the marginal utility will decrease. And this has happened. And the law of diminishing marginal utility drives me to drink tea on a Saturday night. But it's not. That's not the issue in the real world. Because in the real world, it's not just marginal utility that matters, but rather marginal utility per dollar. You think you're buying a Snickers bar. You think you're buying a donut. You think you're buying a soda or whatever. No, you're buying the utility that comes from that. And, so for instance, there's a Ben & Jerry's and a Rite Aid sitting right next to each other. Now everybody says they get more marginal utility from a Ben & Jerry's than from a scoop of Rite Aid ice cream. So I just said 60 versus 25, that's me. Why would anybody, when they get more marginal utility from Ben & Jerry's, go to Rite Aid and buy ice cream? Go ahead.
The cost.
How much does a Ben & Jerry's cost, roughly?
Five.
I'd say, you think it's 5?
5 or 4.
I think it's 4, okay. And Rite Aid?
2.
$1. My numbers have to come out. Alright, so, when you buy a scoop of ice cream, when this person buys a scoop of ice cream from Ben & Jerry's, they're buying utils at the rate of 15 per dollar. Whereas if they buy that same scoop at Rite Aid, they're buying utils at the rate of 25 per dollar. That's why people will buy Rite Aid ice cream instead of Ben & Jerry's. If, for instance, a scoop of Ben & Jerry's gave this person 100 utils, marginal utils, then that would be 25 utils per dollar, and they would be indifferent about whether they go to Ben & Jerry's or Rite Aid. Now, you have to excuse me for just a second because this has provoked something, and that is Cherry Garcia ice cream. And Cherry Garcia is named after Jerry Garcia, who used to be the guitarist for the Grateful Dead, a very popular band. But Jerry Garcia died. It was very sad. And after he died, they had to change the name from Cherry Garcia to Barry Garcia. See, because he died and it was like Barry instead of...
Oh.
I get it now.
Okay, I need a break. Excuse me. I just need a break. Excuse me. I've been working way too hard.